introduce yourself?
I'll hold it for you. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Kaidi Lee and I'm portraying Amy in the film Study Abroad.
Yes, and there's a funny story with Kaidi and I, and when I first went to her film, I'm actually part of her film Study Abroad, and
yes.
It was the other way around, right? What was it like?
Yes. But other time it's different because it's I interview you.
Yes.
Then you introduce yourself to me in the film.
Yes. So life is crazy, and now here we are, and interviewing Kaidi. Yes. So
switch.
Yeah, it's a 180-degree switch, right? So, so Kaidi, could you tell us more about what type of projects you're more into? What type of films do you like to be into, or is it every film or?
I think I would love, because I did a short film a lot, and I did when I was a student, I act in a student film, and also Indian film, and I think study abroad is kind of like indie and also like art film. That's what I love. I love art film, but if I have some choice, I would love to try maybe commercial, and maybe some comedy, I think I'm open to all type of films.
Okay. Yeah. So, were you an actress before you started in these films, and what was your background? Did you go to film school?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
I graduated from Beijing Dance Academy in dance major, and also that's my bachelor, and also I have my MFA degree in performing arts.
Okay.
It's in Savannah College for Art and Design. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And when did you know you want to be an actress? Was it just one day you woke up and say, hey, I'm going to be an actress, or something that pushed you to become an actress?
Well, I think it's two choices, actually. So it's a long awakening. It's feel, because I'm really writing, and poem, and also novel, when I was in high school. But I studied Chinese folk singing. And for 5 years, and also I learned dancing maybe over 20 years. So I think, wow, let's see. I think musical is the perfect thing that connect my interests together. So I was how about to try musical? And to, at that time, I think I'm a junior. So it's saying, I'm thinking where I'm going to next move. So I think, okay, I want to take the master and see one major. Okay, let's do theater or musical theater. I think that's more suit to me. And another, the moment, I think it's, I think about a question that, let me think, what's the question? Oh, because I think about the question what I can do, the most great in the whole world. I don't think I could be the best singer, also dancer, because I don't think I have that talent. But I think if I try, I could be a very sincerely actor. I'm not sure, I don't think I could be the top level, but I think I can do better as singer and dancer. So I think, because I have the very deep feeling about people, I really care about human beings. So, I try which is my favorite area. I think maybe acting. And yes, and if I can use maybe dancing and singing as my skills to portray the story I love and also the character I love, I think, and maybe bring the beauty and bring the beauty of human beings and also the thinking from people's heart. I feel that's perfect. So I think that's what I love to do.
So you mentioned you want to incorporate, singing and dancing into film. Have you gotten the opportunity to do that yet?
Yes. Yeah. I act in some musical, a Broadway musical, Chicago, and also La Mancha.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Men of La Mancha.
Okay.
Yeah, we just did it this May.
Wow.
Yeah, in New York.
Okay.
It's really cool. We have a really great team, and we did that in Mandarin and in New York.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we have the permission by the Broadway team and also the Chinese translate team.
Mm-hmm.
So both permission that we can do this, we can use their script in New York.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, and I want to add another one.
Mm-hmm.
the why I want to choose to be an actor, actually it's about a thinking that what will we do at the end of people's world, the last day of us. Like what will we do? And I think about this, and actually at that time I'm really at a dumb place, because I'm really like, I don't believe I could be a good actor at that time, because that's the first year in my study of performing arts. Because everyone want to me that just not to be me. That's really let me like feel so struggle. And
you're
like
trapped,
so life, yeah, I've been trapped and so painful, like to be someone that you don't want to be or something. But that time I feel like it's like a fight, like me fight myself. Yes, at that time I'm thinking about, okay, because my friend, he asked me, okay, so think about this. So what will people do at the last day in our history? And while I'm thinking, he told me his answer. He said, okay, I think people are telling stories about ourselves, about our history. I think, wow, yeah, that's actor's job. We are telling people what happened, what is happening, and what will happen tomorrow. I feel like if people can think about their self or think back or look back about their life and also think about something that maybe happened tomorrow and give you another thought, or I think that will be so great. And that time I feel I just realized how grateful the actor's job is, and how actually I was crying in my professor's lesson. Yeah, at that time, we are doing exercise, so we put a boy, like our peers, our classmates, and we hold him up, everyone hold him up, like, because he's kind of heavy, you know, and we are like just little girls, and we have other boys too, but, and he need to roll up and speak his monologue. And we cannot let him falling down. So everyone try our best to hold him up, and if he's rolling, and he's keep rolling, so everyone's running. Okay, he's running. Okay, run there and get him. At that time, when he's get down, he's crying.
Yes.
And I was so touching at that moment, because I feel like, yes, that's partners on stage, because we are here for each other, and we are here to make you safe. Actually, this feeling is more stronger when you're at theater, because at theater, it won't be cut, it won't be say action. Everything is just come and go, so you don't have second chance, you don't have one chance. So if you get stuck, if you lost your lines, you just stuck on the stage, you die there. And your partner is there to protect you. He need to, I don't know, he need to make this like continue to go and like make the connection with you, or like let's do some improv, or let's do something like fun, interesting to watch. So at that time I feel like, so that's some that different touching moment about my self. I feel like it's how grateful the actor to be an actor. Yes, that how grateful to be an actor in class, that my professor told me, and also my classmates around me, that made me feel how important our partner is, and also how important and grateful and great the actor's job. And we are very important, we are the storyteller. And if it's some kid, it's their first time to come to the theater, and you are the first show in his life, in her life, and you bring the beauty into his or her heart, maybe you change his whole life. Maybe he loved the story, maybe he want to do some research, maybe he think, oh, I want to be actors in the theater. Maybe I want to be some like, someone like in the character, about the character. I want to be a scientist. I want to be like a singer or something. I feel like, yeah, we are, because we are at the spotlight. So you must be very careful about what you did, about what you're gonna say, you need to think very carefully. At that time, like I was really lucky to have this person in my life. So when I was like questioning myself, they always like appear to my life and also give me some like answer when I have my questions. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. Wow, that's very definitely a powerful story and what you went through. So in the near future, do you have any upcoming projects or anything?
Oh yeah, actually I did a short film, it's called Mi Mi. It's a short film about Chinese traditional dress, Hanfu. I don't know if you know that or not, it's Chinese traditional.
Yes.
And it's I always tell people, okay, this is the mother of kimono. And I'll die, you know, like Hanbo. And they are all like from here. So, but Hanfu is, I think right now, like several years later, before I did the film, after I did the film, I think right now it's more and more people to know this. And I think it's 2014, the Spring Festival. Yes, so we did this one, and I think a lot of people love this short film, especially for the Tongpao. So, and I want to bring this story, make it more, make it a feature film, make it bigger, make it more like seriously, and to make it bigger as a bigger project. So I want to make this story, I always think about this because I like think how could we do this story and to some other way, and which way is better. I always think about it like several years, and I think it's the right time to bring this back. So I want to do the feature film of Mimi. It's about the Hanfu, and it's about the secret store. So I think it will be very interesting.
Okay, that's amazing. I can't wait to see that film. Do you have any, how did you like the past couple of days of the film festival, and do you have anything that you want to say to people who might be watching film festivals in the future?
I would definitely recommend this film, film festival to you, because I think the panel, I learned a lot, really. I feel the feeling, I go back to school, and people are really professional here, and they talk about only the professional things, no other things. Yeah, because actually they are one of the speakers is he's a friend of my professor.
Oh wow.
Yeah, we just found this out yesterday. So it's really a strange and but one wonderful feeling, like you meet your teacher's friend somewhere.
Yes.
Yeah. And I feel like wow, yeah, we are still in the same industry. I'm still in the market.
Yes.
I think I know a lot like great filmmakers here. They are very nice, very nice, and they are very passionate. And I think they all think about, they are talk about the love about film and say like, if you do have a story to tell, go for it. And they're always aware, don't give up, and keep your love to film. And I was so touching that, like yesterday. I would feel, and everyone telling this, everyone are encourage people, and everyone tell them, don't give up, we are here for you, and everyone we are struggle as your struggle, we are doing the same thing, we are going the same way. I feel yeah, we are at the same spot. Yes.
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm not alone.
Yes, you're certainly not, and there are so many inspiring filmmakers here and producers. So thank you so much, Kaidi, and
yes.
I look forward to seeing your film.
Thank you so much, and welcome to see the film festival.